It's hard to talk about the Scarface Gang without feeling a sense of fear and trepidation. But there's a reason why this notorious gang is one of the most feared in Europe, and to know all about them, watch the video till the end. The Scarface Gang, a group of audacious and stylish criminals, seem like they stepped straight off a movie set. With their expensive BMWs and Audis, trendy clothing and sunglasses, they appeared unfazed by anything. However, their notoriety stemmed from their involvement in 8 well-planned and highly violent robberies across 3 countries and over 40 smaller crimes. The gang's name was inspired by one of the biggest gangster movies of all time, and they caught the attention of the Belgian police in early 2011. The gang operated in various formations, sometimes committing crimes with only 2 members, while other times with up to 6, including a female member. Although they were primarily based in Belgium, they weren't hesitant to commit crimes in neighboring countries like the Netherlands and France. Initially, the gang's crimes were small and insignificant, but within a few months, they had escalated to some of the region's most significant and violent cases. On February 16, 2011, in Zult, Belgium, their infamous spree began when they arrived in their Volkswagen Golf to look at a rare BMW M5 with over 500 horsepower that was up for sale. The 2 men arrive to inspect the rare car for sale, and the owner gives them a tour. As they haggle over the price, one of the men suddenly asks to check the chassis number. When the owner lifts the bonnet to show it, he feels a weapon pressed into his back. Though he resists, he eventually hands over the keys as he fears for his life. The men drive off in the BMW after setting fire to their Volkswagen Golf. Little does the owner know that this car will become crucial to the crimes that follow. 3 days later, the BMW is again seen in Wallonia, Belgium. 2 masked armed men storm into a gas station, blocking the entrance and holding the employees captive while one empties the cash registers. They leave with the loot and flee in the BMW, but it's not worth the risk. They fill the car with gas and drive off without paying the following day. The gang is back at it just 2 days later, this time in Leeds, Belgium, with 5 members, including a woman. A jeweler's shop is the target of an armed robbery as 2 masked men storm into the store as soon as the owner answers the door. The owner hits the robbers with a chair to defend himself, but one of them fires 3 shots as a warning. When the jeweler's dog appears, the robbers flee without any loot. The robbers then target a post office in Walheen, Belgium, but their efforts are in vain. Despite investigations by the police, the robbers remain at large. The robbers return to action on March 13th. Targeting a hotel in Mechelen, Belgium. Once again, 2 masked men demand money from the safe, only to discover that it has a time lock that can only be opened at certain times. In desperation, the robbers empty the cash register at the front desk and flee with minimal loot. The police are still investigating the previous robberies, but the robbers are constantly changing the license plates on their cars to avoid detection. However, their vehicle is becoming increasingly conspicuous. On March 16th, the gang of robbers plans yet another heist, targeting a jeweler. There are now 5 of them in total. A man and woman approach a store and ring the bell. The unsuspecting victim opens the door, as they seem like ordinary customers. However, 2 additional men rush into the store and ransack the cabinets. The victim is tied up, and the robbers drive away with some jewelry. Disappointed with their small haul, the gang decides to re-strategize. 2 weeks later, on April 4th, the gang moved to Rotterdam, Netherlands. They break into a secure cash money transport depot with explosives and start looting. Employees try to escape, but 2 are shot by the robbers in the process. The gang steals massive amounts of cash and flees the scene with 2 high-speed cars, a BMW M5 and an Audi RS6. The heist is successful, netting the gang multiple millions in loot. The gang becomes infamous and earns the name the Scarface Gang when they fill up their BMW at a gas station 3 days later, paying for fuel with their newly acquired riches. CCTV footage shows the members dressed in fancy clothes at the gas station. One individual was dressed in the exact attire of Tony Montana from the movie Scarface, complete with a matching blouse, trousers, shoes, and glasses. To complete the look, the individual even wore a wig that mirrored Tony Montana's style from the film. This was one of the final instances where the BMW M5 was observed. The vehicle had become too hot, and the gang knew they had to dispose of it. On April 18th, the gang parked the car in a passage beneath a highway. After dousing the car in gasoline, they set it ablaze. This marked the end of the BMW M5, which they had used to commit countless crimes. However, assuming this was also the end of the Scarface Gang would be a grave mistake. The subsequent week saw yet another robbery occur, this time on a French money transport company called Loomis, which resulted in a haul of $2 million. They utilized the same technique they had employed during the secure cash heist, breaking into the building with powerful explosives and promptly looting as much as possible. Despite the $2 million being a significant sum, they were far from done. This heist was merely a precursor for what was yet to come. Fast forwarding to June 29, 2011 in Amsterdam, the Netherlands, it was a day when numerous people chose to commute by car due to an anticipated storm. Unfortunately, they would spend hours in traffic due to an incident earlier in the day. The police had to close an entire highway to investigate a significant incident in a secluded area of Amsterdam. The area in question was home to a money transport company called Brinks, which had heavily armored trucks transporting cash between banks, stores, and other businesses that dealt in cash. The Brinks building was also heavily fortified with armored doors, camera surveillance, and more. However, none of these precautions could deter the Scarface gang from planning a heist. At around 3 a.m., two Audis, one black and one dark gray, pulled up to the Brinks parking lot, and several individuals disembarked and walked toward the building. Meanwhile, other gang members made their way to the surrounding roads. The group that went toward the building cut open the fence and entered the company's premises. After a short while, they returned to the fence they had cut through, and an enormous explosion ensued, blowing out the armored door of the building. The Brink employees immediately called the police and locked themselves in an office for safety. However, within a few minutes, the robbers had filled large bags with cash and were prepared to leave. The police responded quickly, but the gang had anticipated this and had laid out spike strips around the building and even at the nearest police station, delaying the arrival of law enforcement. In addition, the bags of cash were so heavy that the gang had difficulty loading them into their Audis. While attempting to flee, they encountered police cars. The aftermath of a gunfight was a dangerous and chaotic situation. One of the Audi cars managed to escape, while the other was speeding from police at 240 kilometers per hour. The police lost sight of the car, and despite calling for helicopter assistance, the bad weather conditions prevented any help from above. The robbers had carefully planned this heist, choosing a day with heavy winds and bad weather conditions to eliminate the chance of being followed by a helicopter. However, they had not planned for a crash. The driver was going so fast that he lost control of the car and crashed on the highway. As they exited the car, three unsuspecting men offered to help them but were greeted with automatic rifles. The robbers hijacked their car, a Hyundai i10, but before they could transfer all the cash from the Audi to the Audi exploded. One of the robbers had to be carried into the Hyundai as he could not walk after the crash. All the millions in cash burned out with the Audi. As the Hyundai drove away, a police car caught up with them and one of the robbers pointed his automatic rifle at the pursuing vehicle. The robber demanded that the police car stop chasing them and due to fear for their safety, the police car complied. The Hyundai subsequently vanished, marking the tail of the notorious Scarface gang. This gang committed more than 40 minor crimes and 8 highly violent ones. They evolved from conducting robberies with little to no profit to heists that yielded millions in cash. Some members were caught, some fled, and were never found, and one allegedly died in the Amsterdam heist after crashing their vehicle. The Scarface gang amassed over $15 million in under a year, and since 2011, there have been no updates on their activities. Thank you for watching our video today. Please comment below in the comments section. Hit the bell to receive notifications when we upload new videos to this channel and subscribe for more.